Hi children, in the last class we discussed about the introduction of the third lesson, making friends. In this class, let's start the drama. Blazing, to burn with bright, strong flames. The sun is blazing in the noon. Crimson, a dark red color. She blushed crimson with embarrassment. Shabby, lack of care. The room was empty except for a shabby bed. Genteel poverty, having little money but high social standing. They are safe in their genteel poverty. Shovel, a tool used for picking up and moving earth, snow, sand, etc. The men were working with picks and shovels. Next. Scene 1. The scene is set in a drawing room. The room has two sofas facing each other, two deep chairs, a cupboard, and a large coffee table. Between the sofas is the fireplace where a small cheerful fire is blazing. The sofas and chairs are covered with pretty but faded cloth. The curtains at the windows are crimson, bright ones, now faded to a dull color. The effect is one of shabby but genteel poverty. A young girl is reading on one of the sofas, her feet stretched towards the fire. This is Meg. She looks up as another young girl walks in wearing rubber boots and a hooded cape with a broom in one hand and in a shovel in the other. The scene takes place in a drawing room. The room has two sofas, two deep chairs, a cupboard, and a large coffee table. Between the sofas, there is a fireplace. It means a place for keeping a fire, where a small cheerful fire is blazing. Means here, blazing means burn with strong flames. The sofas and chairs are covered with a cloth. The cloth was beautiful and it was a dull color. The curtains at the windows are crimson, means a red color, bright one, now it is turned into a dull color. The effect is one of shabby, means the curtains are lack of care because it is turned into a dull color. A young girl is reading, she is sitting on the sofa and she is reading a book. She stretched her feet towards the fireplace and she is warming her feet thoroughly. This is Meg. She was Meg. I have told you that Meg was the elder sister who was somebody. She was beautiful and fond of luxurious. Meg looks up to an young girl who is walking in front of her. The young girl wore rubber boots and a hooded cape with a broom in one hand and a tool which is in the other. Meg, what in the world are you going to do now, Joe? Meg asked to Joe, what is going outside? What are you doing? What are you going to do now? Meg, going out for some exercise. She smiles. Joe replied with a smile, I am going out for some exercise. Meg, horrified, exercise on a cold, cold day like this? After listening Joe's reply, Meg questioned her with horrifiedly. Have you gone mad? Are you going for exercise on a school day, on such a cold day like this? Joe, you can sit here and read Ivanhoe and toast your feet. I am going out. Here, Ivanhoe means a historical novel on the adventures. Some people like to read Ivanhoe. Toast your feet means to warm thoroughly. He is toasting his feet by the fire. Joe told to the Meg, "You sit here and read Ivanhoe, a historical book on adventures. Warm your feet thoroughly. I am going out now." Joe exits left. Meg stares after her sister. Joe manages her and she left. Meg look at Joe for a long time. Meg, Joe shrugs her shoulder. She can never sit still for even a moment, but she will be back soon, complaining of the cold and telling me how her feet and ears and fingers are frozen and ready to drop off. Here, shrugs means to lift your shoulders as a way of showing that you don't know something. He shrugged my shoulders. Next, frozen. Frozen means stored at a low temperature in order to keep it for a long time. When water freezes, it becomes ice. Drop off, to fall into a light sleep. I dropped off in front of the television. Meg told to the Joe, "You never sit still for a moment, but after that again you will come back soon and complaining me about the weather and told how your feet, ears and fingers are turned into ice and ready to fall asleep." A little later, Jo enters with an excited look on her face. A few minutes after, Jo enters with a joyful look on her face. "Jo, do you know where I am going now?" Jo asks to the Meg, "Do you know, Meg, where I am going now?" Meg looks up startled. Startled means to disturb. The monkeys were so startled that they ran off in all directions. Meg looks up towards the Joe and looking her to a disturbed look. Meg, "Oh, it's you, Joe. You startled me. What's the matter? It is too cold for you?" Meg asked to the Joe, "Oh, Joe, it's you. You scared me. What's the reason? Are you feeling too cold?" Joe, "Not a bit. I have finished clearing the snow and sweeping a path around the garden." Joe told to the Meg, "Not a bit. I have just finished clearing the snow and sweeping a path around the garden." "Have you seen the Lawrence boy who lives in that stately mansion on the other side of the edge?" Joe asked to the Meg, Have you seen that Lawrence boy who lives in that stately mansion?" Here mansion means a very large house. They live in a mansion. "Have you seen that Lawrence boy who lives in that large house on the other side of the boundary? I wonder if he is gone away. I think he is gone away. Or maybe his grandpa doesn't know what's good for him and keeps him shut all day. Or maybe his grandfather doesn't know what is good for Lawrence boy and kept him and stops him all day. He needs somebody young and lively. I think that Lawrence boy needs somebody who is young and exciting. I have a good mind to go over and tell the old gentleman so. I have a idea to go through that and tell about that the Lawrence grandpa so. We'll continue the second scene in my next video. Thank you.